Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's learn about waves.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We have already examined one kind of vibration when we looked at springs and Hooke's law, and the periodic motion that results. Now let's look at another type of vibration that can also result in periodic motion, waves. These should be quite familiar if you've ever been to the beach, but those aren't the only kinds of waves. Light and sound can both be considered waves as well, so we will need to learn about the properties of waves. Waves always originate with some event or disturbance, like a pebble falling into a pond, and this disturbance will then propagate outwards from this point. In this way, we can consider any wave to be a kind of traveling disturbance that carries energy from place to place. Apart from the radial waves on the pond, waves can also be strictly linear, like if you shake a taut rope. In both cases, the wave is traveling through a material medium, so they are called mechanical waves. Mechanical waves can be transverse waves, where the disturbance is perpendicular to the direction the wave is traveling, or longitudinal waves, where the disturbance is parallel to the direction the wave is traveling, either by compression or rarefaction. With mechanical waves, the medium does not travel with the wave, just the energy is carried by the wave. So in the ocean, the wave will travel a great distance, but any individual water molecule won't go too far. It is only energy that travels along with the wave. The same can be said for people doing the wave at a stadium. The wave travels, but all of the people stay in their own seats. However, not all waves are mechanical waves. Some do not require a medium to travel through, like any kind of electromagnetic wave, which we know of as light. These waves can travel through the vacuum of space, which is why we are able to see celestial objects in the night sky. A wave whose source is a vibration with simple harmonic motion will be a sine wave, because the periodic motion of the wave produces a graph of the trigonometric function y equals sine x. We need to label a few details with sine waves. First, there is the amplitude of the wave. For a transverse wave like this, the amplitude is the displacement of the wave in the direction perpendicular to the direction of its motion, or the distance from the middle to a crest or trough. The greater the amplitude, the more energy the wave carries with it, which is why you shouldn't try to surf 30-foot waves unless you are an expert. In addition, each wave will carry a wavelength, represented by the Greek letter lambda. This is the length of one cycle of the wave, which is easily measured from one crest to the next. The time required to complete one cycle is called the period. There will also be a frequency, which is the number of wavelengths that pass by a particular spot per unit time, represented by the Greek letter nu. Frequency will typically be measured in hertz, which are inverse seconds, meaning the number of waves that occur per second. We will learn all kinds of math associated with graphing these sine curves in the upcoming mathematics course. For now, we can just stick to a qualitative discussion. Sound is also brought to our ears through waves, though these are longitudinal waves. A sound initiates with a vibration, like a plucked string. This vibration requires a medium in which to travel, like a solid, liquid, or gas. Sound can't travel in a vacuum, which is why there is no sound in space, despite what you hear in movies. Typically, sound travels through the air, causing vibrations in atmospheric molecules as it passes, just like a wave in the ocean does to water molecules. Each sound wave will carry a frequency that is equal to the frequency of the vibration that initiated it. The speed at which the wave will travel is equal to the wavelength times the frequency, and mechanical waves will travel at a constant speed for any given medium, though that speed is different depending on the particular medium. Interestingly, sound travels 4 times faster in water than air, and 17 times faster through steel than air. but when we refer to the speed of sound, we typically mean as it moves through the atmosphere, which will be constant, since a greater frequency will be accompanied by a smaller wavelength. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.